Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why U. So far, we have seen that factoring a quadratic expression into a pair of linear expressions is one of the primary methods used to solve quadratic equations. In the previous lecture, we introduced a method for factoring quadratics using a trial and error process called factoring by inspection. We saw that this process is simplest when the coefficient of x squared is 1, since in that case, the x coefficients p and r in the linear factors will also be 1. Therefore, it will only be necessary to determine the values of two constants, q and s, given the values of b and c. However, when the coefficient of x squared is not 1, we must not only determine values for q and s, but also values for p and r, given the values of three constants a, b, and c. In this lecture, we will see how to factor a quadratic by inspection when the coefficient of x squared is not 1. As in the previous lecture, we will assume that the quadratic expression has been put into general form where a, b, and c are integers. If the x squared coefficient a is not 1, the first step is to look for any common factors of a, b, and c. In some cases, factoring out the greatest common factor can produce a quadratic expression with an x squared coefficient of 1. For instance, let's say we wish to factor the quadratic expression 2x squared plus 10x plus 12. Since 2 is a common factor of all three terms, we can write this expression as 2 times a quadratic with an x squared coefficient of 1. We can then factor the quadratic by inspection as we did in the previous lecture. In that lecture, we determined that the factors of this quadratic were x plus 2 and x plus 3. So the original quadratic expression, 2x squared plus 10x plus 12, can be written as the product of three factors, 2, x plus 2, and x plus 3. The zero product property tells us that the zeros of the function defined by this quadratic expression are identical to the zeros of the functions defined by each of its factors. The first factor, 2, is a constant function that has no zeros, since regardless of the value of x, the value of that constant function will never be 0. The second factor, x plus 2, is a linear function that has a 0 of negative 2. Likewise, the third factor, x plus 3, is a linear function with a 0 of negative 3. And the zero product property tells us that these zeros are also the zeros of the quadratic function. In some cases, the values of a, b, and c may not allow us to produce a quadratic expression with an x squared coefficient of 1. Take, for example, the quadratic 6x squared minus 15x plus 9. Although all three terms have a common factor of 3, once we factor out the 3, the remaining quadratic expression will be simpler to factor by inspection. However, we are still not left with the quadratic whose x squared coefficient is 1. So how do we go about factoring a quadratic like this using the inspection method? To factor this quadratic expression, we wish to find two linear expressions that, when multiplied together, produce the quadratic. To multiply these linear expressions, we use the FOIL method to take the product of their first terms plus the product of their outer terms plus the product of their inner terms plus the product of their last terms. The quadratic's x squared term will then be equal to the product of the factor's x terms. Likewise, the quadratic's constant term will be equal to the product of the factor's constant terms. And the quadratic's x term will be equal to the product of the factor's outer terms plus the product of the factor's inner terms. So to find a pair of linear factors whose product produces the quadratic, we will start by making a list of all the pairs of linear factors whose product of x terms equals the quadratic's x squared term, and whose product of constant terms equals the quadratic's constant term. Then from these pairs of linear factors, we will look for a pair whose product of outer terms plus product of inner terms is equal to the quadratic's x term. So as our first example, let's factor the quadratic expression 5x squared plus 9x minus 2. We start by listing all the possible pairs of linear factors whose product of x terms is 5x squared and product of constant terms is negative 2. One choice for x terms, whose product is 5x squared, is x and 5x. So we will make a table under this heading for all possible pairs of linear factors whose first terms are x and 5x. Another choice of x terms whose product is 5x squared could be 5x and x. But making another table of factors with the same two x terms is not necessary, since this would just produce the same pairs of factors with their order swapped. We could have also reversed the signs, making another table with x terms of negative x and negative 5x. However, we still would have ended up with the same pairs of linear factors with all the signs reversed, and this would have produced the same solutions to the quadratic equation. Now, under this table heading, we will make a list of all the possible pairs of factors whose product of constant terms is negative 2. The possible values for constant terms whose product is negative 2 are positive 1 and negative 2, positive 2 and negative 1, negative 1 and positive 2, and negative 2 and positive 1. We now have four pairs of factors to test to see if the sum of outer and inner products is 9x. Calculating the sum of the first pair of factors, outer and inner products, the outer product, negative 2 times x, plus the inner product, 1 times 5x, is 3x. Likewise, we calculate the sum of the outer and inner products in the second factor pair, the third factor pair, and the fourth factor pair. We can see from these calculations that only the second pair has a sum of outer and inner products that equals 9x. Therefore, the factors of this quadratic expression are x plus 2 and 5x minus 1. Although in this example we tested all four pairs of factors, we could have stopped once we discovered that the second pair produced the correct result. It is never necessary to continue testing factors once a set of factors is found that works. In this last example, even though the coefficient of x squared was not 1, factoring by inspection was still fairly simple, involving only four pairs of factors to check. This was because the quadratic's x squared coefficient, 5, and its constant term, negative 2, had a small number of factors, so very few combinations were produced. In fact, the only integer factors of 5 and 2 are 1 and 5 and 1 and 2. However, when the constants a and c in a quadratic expression have more factors, factoring by inspection can sometimes require a considerable amount of trial and error. In those cases, it is preferable to use methods such as completing the square or the quadratic formula, which we will introduce in the next several lectures. As an example, factoring the quadratic expression 12x squared plus 19x minus 18 requires us to consider a number of different pairs of factors for both 12 and 18, producing a large number of combinations. To illustrate this, let's try factoring this quadratic by inspection. Just like in the previous example, we will start by listing all possible pairs of linear factors whose product of x terms is 12x squared and product of constant terms is negative 18. One choice for x terms whose product is 12x squared is x and 12x. Other possible choices whose product is 12x squared are 2x and 6x, and 3x and 4x. As we have showed, we do not need to pick these same x terms with the order reversed, or signs reversed. Now, the possible constant terms whose product is negative 18 are 1 and negative 18, 2 and negative 9, 3 and negative 6, 6 and negative 3, 9 and negative 2, 18 and negative 1, and then the same constant terms with their signs reversed. This gives us 36 different factor pairs whose product of x terms is 12x squared and product of constant terms is negative 18. We now look for a factor pair from this list whose sum of outer and inner products is 19x. Adding the outer products for each factor pair to the inner products for each factor pair, we get these results. From this, we see that only one factor pair in this list has a sum of outer and inner products that equals 19x. Therefore, the factors of this quadratic expression are 3x minus 2 and 4x plus 9. Although the inspection method is sometimes the quickest way to factor a quadratic, factoring this quadratic turned out to be quite a lengthy process, since in this case, there were many possible factors that needed to be considered. In addition, some quadratics are impossible to factor by inspection, such as the example we saw in the lecture Factoring Quadratics by Inspection, Part 1. Over 1,000 years ago, problems like this prompted mathematicians to search for a technique that could be used to solve any quadratic equation. The breakthrough in devising a general method was the development of a technique called completing the square. In the next lecture, we will introduce this method.